हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू द एक्साइटिंग वर्ल्ड ऑफ लर्निंग मैथमेटिक्स. ओके, सी इन द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ 3.3 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक, वी हैव स्टडीड द मेथड, सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड टू सॉल्व द पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन. इन योर एक्सरसाइज ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर फर्स्ट, सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस बाय द सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड. वी हैव सिक्स क्वेश्चंस हियर. So first question is very easy that you can solve. Okay, the question number 2 is here, s minus t. See, two variables here, s and t. S minus t is equal to 3 and s by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. We have these two equations. Okay, and we have to solve by substitution method. So first of all, as you know the algorithm, you know the process to solve the question. First we solve the equation number 1. Solving equation 1, or we can write s is equal to 3 plus t. Now we put this value in the next equation, that is the equation number 2. That is called substituting. This you can put the equation number 3 name. Substituting the value of s in equation 2. So when you put in this equation, we will get, instead of s you have to write this 3 plus t whole divided by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. Now we need to take the LCM of these two. Okay, when you take the LCM of 3 and 2, that is the product itself, 3 into 2, 6. And should be multiplied by 2, and this should be multiplied by 3. Now we need to transfer this 6 to the right side. 2 times of this becomes 6 plus 2t, and here 3t. Now transfer this 6 to the right side, it will be multiplied. Okay, 6 6 are 36. Now see, 3t and 2t, we have a 5t, and this to move right side. So we have a 5t is equal to 30, and hence we will get t equal to 30 by 5, that is 6. So we got t equal to 6, that is our first answer. Then we put the value of t in any of the equation. Now you can put the value of t in any equation. Now putting substituting भी बोल सकते हो, putting the value of t in equation 3, in this equation we are putting, so we will get s is equal to 3 plus 6, that is 9, s equal to 9. See, after getting the values of s and t, you can verify your result, okay, whether this is correct or not. So when you put the value of s equal to 9 here and the value of t 6, so s 9 minus 6 equal to 3, that is correct. So this is the answer, s equal to 9, t equal to 6, correct. Now see the one more question, the question number 5. Here it is given, the question number 5, root 2 time x, first ka 5, root 2 times x plus root 3 times of y is equal to 0. Root 3 times x minus root 8 y times y, that also 0. So this is the our first equation, root 2 x plus root 3 y is equal to 0, and the second equation, root 3 x minus root 8 y equal to 0. Solving the equation, any one of them, yeah, from the equation 1 you can write solving equation 2, because the minus sign is there, root 3x minus 8y equal to 0, transfer this term like this, so we'll get x is equal to root 8 by root 3 times of y, correct. Now we shall put this value in equation 1. substituting the equation, keep this name equal to 3. Substituting the value of x in equation 1. Root 2 times of just see the RHS is 0. Root 2 should be multiplied with that. We will get root 16. Root 3. See the LCM we can take here. Here it is 1. Root 3 and 1. Its LCM will be root 3 only. In denominator, 4 by. Take y outside. Common. Looks better. Okay. Now we'll take the LCM. There is 1 root 3 into 1, that become root 3. Now you divide root 3 by root 3, you will get 1 only. So here it will be 4 itself. But when you divide the root 3 by 1, we will get root 3. And root 3 will be multiplied with the numerator root 3. It become 3. Clear? Now 4 plus 3, 7 by root 3 times of y is equal to 0. So y become transfer this term to the right side, 0 into whatever, it will be 0 only. So y equal to 0. And when you put this value in equation number 3, that also putting the value in equation 3. Here x equal to this time of 0, that also 0. So x 0 and y 0, this is the answer. Clear? Now let's see one more question, that is the question number 4. Point 2 times of x plus 0.3 times of y, that is equal to 1.3, and the equation number 2, 0.4 x plus 0.5 y, that is 2 point. So equation 1 is 0.2x plus 0.3y is equal to 1.3, and the equation, next equation is 0.4x plus 0.5y is equal to 2.3. See only the 1 figure after the decimal, so you can remove the decimal by multiplying by 10 on both sides. So we can simplify the equation. Okay, when you multiply the equation by 10, it becomes easy to look. When you multiply both sides by 10, on the equation number 1 will become 2x plus 3y equal to 13. This you name equation number 3. Okay, similarly, multiplying by 10. Okay, similarly, you can multiply the second equation also. 10 times of 0.4x plus 0.5y, 10 times of 2.3. So, you will get a new and simplified, looks little better. This is the equation number, you can put it 4. Clear? Now, we can simplify any one of them. So just simplifying equation 3. We can write from equation 3. Okay, from equation 3, so 2x plus 3y equal to 13. So we can write 2x is equal to 13 minus 3y, and hence x equal to 13 minus 3y divided by 2. Now substituting this value in the next equation, okay, that is 4. You just, you may put the name 5. Substituting the value of x in equation 5, in this equation. Okay, so we have, sorry, in equation 4. So we have 4 time of x, 13 minus 3y whole divided by 2 plus 5 times y is equal to 23. See here it is in bracket, so we can cut it. 2 से इसको कट कर सकते हैं. 2 times 13 minus 3y, 5y equal to 23. Now open the bracket, this will be 26 minus 6y plus 5y is equal to 23. Correct? So here minus 6y plus 5y, we'll get minus y here. 23 minus 26, so we'll get minus y is equal to minus 3. That means y is equal to minus 3 divided by minus 1. Minus 1 cancel out. Y equal to 3. Now we will put the value of y in equation number 5. Putting the value of y in equation 5. In this equation, so we'll get x is equal to 13 minus 3 times of y whole divided by 2. That is 13 minus 9 divided by 2. That is 4 by 2. 2. So we'll get x equal to 2. Correct? So these are the solution, x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. Clear? See, one more question. Here the question number 3. See, 3x minus y is equal to 3. 9x minus 3y is equal to 9. Now, जैसे आप लोग को याद होगा, see, on solving one of the equation, एक को हम solve करके, उसका value दूसरे में substitute कर रहे थे. तो इन दोनों equation को देखिए, if you multiply it by 3, this equation, first को आप 3 से multiply कर दोगे, तो you will get the second equation. Meaning, it means both the equations are almost similar. So, यहाँ पे दो equation है ही नहीं. Means, both the equations are same only. So, this you cannot solve. This question you cannot solve. Let's see what is happening. So, if you rewriting the equation number 1, solving equation 1, so 3x minus y equal to 3, we can write 3x equal to 3 plus y, means y equal to 3x minus 3. When you put this value in equation number 2, substituting the value of y in equation 2, so what shall we get? 9x minus 3 times of, just see here you will get 9x plus 9. Here when you transfer this, 9x minus 9 minus 9, that is also 0 equal to 0. So what are you getting? Just see, 0 equal to 0. So you cannot solve this. So you may say this may be called infinite many solution. This type of, and we will study it in detail. Okay. So I hope now you can solve some more of the questions. So you try to solve the first question, means first and sixth question. Okay. If any doubt, then ask. Till now, all the best.